Hey, this is Agent 355.
And I'm Olish.
And we're playing Darkest Dungeon. Or we will be once we get there.
This is a very good game.
It is a very good game. I like it a lot. Remember when I was running around this area and I was like, remember episode 2 when I was running around this area and I was like, I know I'm forgetting something. Well, I finally remember what I was forgetting. There's a button over here. This one's really sneaky.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
It's at a dead end. You'd never need to go, and it's kind of well hidden because it's covered with vines. So.
I mean, it's very video game logic. It's like, well, there's this place where there's nothing there. Obviously, if we're going to hide something, it's going to be there.
That's true.
Bear claw gauntlets.
we found a bear claw. Delicious, made of pastry. Increases your strength. Remember, throwing weapons are based on strength, so this actually gives me +4 to both of my weapons, so mathematically it works out better for Smash Mouth than it would for the Minotaur. Even though it makes more thematic sense than El Cowjay, but it actually makes more game sense to put it on Smash Mouth.
And you should give it to Smash Mouth and then give him potions so that when he runs out of throwing weapons, he can turn into a bear with his bear claw.
That's true. I never actually thought about using the potions of bear form and giving them to somebody else. I could make the Minotaur turn into a bear. I wonder if that would work.
No, give it to Smash Mouth, because he's got noodly arms, and they totally work.
That's true. I could give him to Smash Mouth and use noodly arms.
Uh-oh.
I forgot about this. I actually was like, wait a minute, I thought I had that one already.
Robin.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, how do you not have an achievement based around catching all the fish?
I think it was actually an error. We're gonna see another achievement that I already had pop up. So I don't know why it popped up. I think it might have been a Steam error. So we went and talked to that thing. If you remember, that one made some reference to my silent friend has a brother or something.
Right. Yeah.
And the silent friend probably refers to this head that's over here.
Also doesn't talk.
Who doesn't talk, which makes sense. And it says, what did it say? East through the gate, right? Or no, it actually said the direction the sun rises through the gate.
But that's east.
So that's east. So we gotta go this way, I guess?
It'd be really funny if the map were just oriented wrong. So map thinks it's north, but if you actually look at where the sun is...
That would be... Or the compass, because they do give you a compass.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
And that would be funny. Welcome to Creep Town. Population this place.
Oh, it's just more of these, like, little woodsy things. Fog effect is kind of nice, although I imagine it gets old.
It is kind of cool. I like that each area feels kind of unique, but the lack of transition areas kind of makes it stand out pretty bad. You know? Because every time you go through a gate, you go from bright sunny to, oh my god, poisonous fog. Like, which was obviously the swamp, not this place, but...
Big whiffa. Yeah.
I know, I mean, Smash Mouth has 3 points in accuracy, and he still misses a ton. Like, game just doesn't want you to hit things.
I mean, I guess it's fine. Accuracy's not meaningful if you're always hitting things all the time.
Right, yes. And at the same time, I mean, all I really want them to do is balance the encounters so they take a roughly appropriate amount of time.
Yeah.
Right? And so, and if that's true, then it doesn't really matter if you hit for all the time for no damage or just rarely for big damage.
Hmm.
So we've got these tombstones around. That's the first one, but there's more. I don't know why I did that. I really didn't like that bush, I guess.
Well, normally death and decay don't really feed the growth of knowledge.
Unless, you know, it's something that grows on dead things. Like the red fern from that one book that made me cry as a 10-year-old.
Where the red fern grows?
Yeah, that was a good book.
But that has nothing to do... What is wrong with you?
Well, that's what the red fern... No, the red fern grew on the dead dog. That's the whole thing. That's
it's
why
not
it was the
knowledge.
Red... Yeah, but it made things grow.
Yeah, so would poop.
I just left it a poop joke. I'm 5 years old.
Was it even a poop joke?
That's true. It was a poop statement, but you said the word poop, so I laughed. I'm 5 years old. We just wasted a lockpick on more bullets. I have 180 bullets, and they each do 2 damage apiece, so that's good. if I shot every single bullet and they all hit and didn't jam, it would take 6 minutes and cost $100,000.
You really need a better gun.
Well, we do have that better gun. Remember, we got the Blunderbuss, but it, or the Arbalest, but it required 3M firearms,
yeah,
which we now have. Yeah. So,
hell, we can do, it's about so, time.
I'm out of gun juice. So now we have a bigger gun, and the most important thing, does it sound better?
Yes.
It does. It does. Sounds a lot better.
Also, that's a pretty significant refire.
Yeah, it shoots kind of... It's not the fastest shooting thing in the world, but it does do, like, triple the damage of the flintlock, so... And I have 180 bullets, so I'm pretty sure I can use them with reckless abandon and not have to worry about it.
Yet you're not.
Well, yeah, but these enemies were from the second zone, if you remember. So those little tree enemies are total chumps.
Listen, I wanted to see some reckless abandon, okay? If this were a fish video, I'd be looking for gills gone wild.
Nope, sorry, the poop joke's better.
We can't all be winners.
So Ganon died here. Somebody threw a tennis racket at him. There's some cool looking sword, I guess, behind that, but we don't have a gold key, so we could have saved that. We could have saved some of the ones that we used in the cache, I guess, if you knew this was here. I'm not sure if it would actually be worth it or not. It'd be kind of funny if it was, but I never really liked doing that really gamey stuff. So it said that this head over here, which I talked over while we talked it earlier, says something like the gates are closed, the answer lies in the archives. Yeah, so we can't actually go through the gate to the east yet.
I bet you have to push that rock in the right direction.
Probably. It's probably or there's a code like south, north, north or something.
Northwest, southwest.
Could be. Something like that. Up, up, down, down, left, right, left, right. So now we had three options. They told us we could go west to the ruins of Desarm, we could go north to the pyramid, or we could go east to the graveyard, or what do you call it? And then the pyramid was closed and the graveyard was closed. So really, we had no options at all.
Yeah.
So now we're in the darkest dungeon.
No, we're not.
No? That's too bad.
I mean, you've clearly got light.
Well, that's the spell. So here we are, Ruins of Desarune, which is a great name.
I wonder if that's the island's department of Dedunzu apartment.
There's a plinth. We can't get up to it. I don't know what it says about this dungeon when the very first two things I ran into are gates you can't open.
You should find a princess to kith it.
Hey, look, it's an ice dude.
I remember guys that were very similar to this.
Yeah, there's elementals. We saw some in the last game. We saw fire ones and lightning ones, I think. I'm not sure if there were any ice ones. There probably were.
I don't think we've seen any fire elementals in this game yet.
No, we've definitely not seen them in this game. I still love that it looks down when I look down.
Of course.
That's still like that's my favorite new feature by far.
And of course, the magic bridge with a slight gap. Bronze brace. Not a bracer?
Nope. It is a wristband. It gives me crit. So, what's going on this guy? Smash Mouth gets all the good items. But that does mean he has a 23% chance to crit, so that's pretty cool.
How does his accuracy actually compare? It's significantly higher, yeah.
Yeah, it was like double, so... Now, I don't know what that actually means in terms of the game. I don't know if it's an opposed roll versus defense or dodge or whatever. Yeah, I don't know. Or whether it's some other type. So, it might not actually be twice as accurate. It could mean something else. Who knows? Math.
Maybe it's just, you know, 17 points more accurate.
Yeah, for all I know, it could be like a 5% increased chance to hit.
Skyway, huh? Oh, I see. So maybe you have to hold down these buttons with things to be able to go across it.
Yeah. You see, a couple of buttons are already held down. One's by meat and one's by bombs, actually. We're going to take that.
Oh, and when you have nothing on the buttons, a different door opens.
Yeah, so one door is open when there's nothing on the buttons, and then there's another way out over here which is open anyway. We're going to go this way first.
Totally waiting for something to attack you through one of those grates. Yeah.
My favorite enemies. I hit someone with the arbalest. It was pretty cool. I think it did like 90 damage, which is a lot better than the old gun did.
It certainly is.
Well, that one was not the best example.
I mean, to be fair, these are also pretty weak enemies. A fist dagger.
It is a light weapon.
Yeah.
It's dexterity based. It has no business in my inventory at all.
I kind of wonder what that special attack is. It's probably just like double damage.
Could be. It could be some like or a piercing attack or something. Who knows? I don't really know. So a lot of the weapons have special things. I'm thinking about what I want to do with those two crystal flowers. I don't use them in this video, but I have two of them now, and I don't think they do any good just hanging around in my inventory. So I'm thinking about, I don't know, giving the cow dex so we can hit more often, or maybe giving giving the mage more concentration so he has even more or more energy.
Well, someone in the thread did say that the rat will eventually make more of them.
Yeah, but I need only one in there, so at the very least I could use one and not hurt my chance of making more of them.
Yeah, absolutely.
So here's our friend. Let's go fight him. Or release him. Okay. Well, I guess we gotta walk back around.
I do like how the Grimrock
engine
has...
Isn't it the darkest dungeon? Yeah, now you have proof. It really is pitch black, and there's very, very few torches. If you did not have the light spell, you would have had to have a big old pile of torches.
Which, I mean, could have.
So this guy's whole gimmick is is if you are standing right next to him, he does that attack, which hits your entire party.
As opposed to the other attack, which also hits your entire party?
Right, but the melee one actually does more damage, as far as I can tell.
Oh, their AI doesn't seem to have the new Grimrock, too.
The new fancy attack you in a bunch of ways? Yeah. Not as far as I know. Although they can actually go up and down. So if we were on the lower level, you could come down to get us.
Scroll of Fireball.
One day. Next level, I'll probably put another point in Fire Magic to give us that Fireball, because that would be cool. We haven't had a ranged AoE attack for the mage yet. I don't know what it takes to cast Lightning Bolt. Well, I do, but, I mean, in-game, I don't know what it takes to cast Lightning Bolt, but we don't have the magic to do that either. So the door that opened this way means that you can't have anything on the ground
ahead of time.
But of course, it's still pretty obvious what you have to do.
Drop stuff through.
Sure. Or even easier, just drop one of our 33 rocks and as you go. Of course, this does mean we can't go back down and get our rocks, though.
I mean, you could. You just have to not close the entire area. There's still a spot you can drop through.
Well, maybe on the way out we could come back and get them, but we can't actually... If we drop down to pick them up, the door would be closed, so...
Well, yeah. I mean, while you're just in this subsection.
Yeah, if we had to come, we might have to come back, I guess. But for right now, there's no way to continue and keep the rocks.
Well, you better rescue those rocks on your way out. That's all I'm saying.
They are completely defenseless. I would not be able to live with myself if I left them there all by themselves. Luckily, they have 9 of them to keep each other company.
And here's your handy-dandy safe crystal.
And here's the Scroll of Light, which if you did not already cheat and know what it did, there you go. I cheated, though, so we're going to drop it down the hole.
Well, you didn't look down the hole, though.
Possibly no, I didn't.
Because you have no other way to go.
Well, actually, there's a particular thing. Of course, you know my penchant for jumping down holes, right?
Yeah.
Well, suffice it to say, the very first thing I did in there before even saving was jumping down that hole. And I wish I didn't. Because if you don't come this way and open up that door... Hey, Cthulhu. If you don't come in this way and open up that door, there's no way to open it from the other side.
Oh.
So you have to. So you are forced to keep going forward until you are able to come back. But, if you remember, way back when, we actually got rope.
Nice.
I wonder if this works. I'm trying to figure out where I want to put it. Like, yeah, I'll put it up here.
That just climb down without hurting yourself.
Yeah, but you know, I jump down all of the holes, and I really don't like breaking my feet and walking slowly, so I'm pretty okay with that.
Just a little bit disappointed fantastic. It doesn't let you climb back up.
That's true. It does not let you climb back up. So here we have a complete dead end.
Or is it?
No, it's game over. Stuck.
Except for the button on the wall.
Oh, okay, there was a button. That's too bad. There's actually nothing in there. It's really pointless.
Sort of make you think that you're trapped, like in the old Ultima games, where you'd fall into a pit and be in a one-by-one room.
This is for that guy in the thread.
Creepy-ass spider.
To be fair, this particular spider is not going to jump at us yet, so I think he's safe for that guy is safe for now.
So it's gonna be this one.
But now the threat's there, so now you know at any point we could get creepy jump scare spiders. Anyone who didn't watch the first video, you're in for a treat because I love creepy jump scare spiders. And if you listen, you can hear one through the wall.
Which is funny, because spiders don't actually make noises.
This is when I realized that I haven't looked down one of these things yet, and people might be wondering what's down there.
It appears to be molten hot magma.
It is. No, yeah, it's. Wait, no, hold on. It's lava, because it's above ground, right? I can't remember. Which way is it at work?
Lava is above ground, magma is below.
Yeah, I got it right. Woo!
But I think we're underground.
Well, that's true, we are underground, but we can see the lava. Does that still make it lava?
Where's GF when you need him?
I don't know. So there's nothing down here except for this button.
Which almost certainly releases that spider behind you.
It must be jumping. It's going to jump and scare me as soon as I turn around, so be ready. Oh, no, I guess it didn't.
What a wasted opportunity.
But
unless
I
it's
have
that
a button
pressure plate.
I have a pressure plate right behind me. But what happens when I push it? And you see there's a pressure plate right there, too, but I can't reach it.
Oh,
spider's gone.
You teleported the spider to a mysterious location.
He could be anywhere now.
That's even better.
Also, there's all those buttons over there. But can't reach those buttons either, so I don't know what that's about. What's upstairs? So here's the room that we came in, that we saw Cthulhu through. Actually, I guess it's not really Cthulhu, it's a Mind Flayer, right? Yeah, about right.
They just have the Cthulhu face tentacles.
Yeah, the face tentacle guys. Oh, there's our spider friend. He's walking down the hallway. He's trying to get us. But he can't get to us because there's a teleporter in the way. When he tries, he goes back to the beginning. This is a metaphor for life. We're just going to let this guy play for the next 30 minutes of the video.
Perpetual spider. You dropped him down a pit.
Yeah, he fell down a pit.
Which means he's back downstairs.
Yeah. And here we have these 5 pits that are probably above those buttons. That would make sense.
Yeah.
Let's go back downstairs, see what happened to the spider.
He's probably back in the... Like, you probably have to lure him to a specific place to get him onto the other Switch.
Yeah. So if we look, there's actually three holes above that, and the Switch is in the middle one. So what we have to do is we have to teleport the spider, and we have to time stepping on the Switch so he falls down the middle hole. Makes sense. I don't know why I always derive a sixth sense of satisfaction trying to walk without actually turning and looking where I'm going, just remembering what the layout was. So, I will say Death Perception is hard.
Whoops.
So we're going to go back down and pretend nothing happened. And in the meantime, I'm going to show off my sick exploring without looking skills.
That would be a little bit better if you didn't have to keep correcting.
But, you know, it's pretty good. Okay. The easiest way to look is at his feet, because if you look at his feet, you can see which one he's on.
We just count the number of times he moves.
Well, yeah, but he sometimes takes double move. Or at least the shadow is confusing and makes it look like he does. I would not say it's difficult, obviously. It's obviously not difficult at all. But I did mess up a number of times in my practice run. A number being, you know, two, but, you know. So now we see that some of these five switches are now lit up. So we can kind of guess what we need to do.
So you need to lure more spiders into your trap.
Yeah, three more. Get them on those switches. We, from the upper story, are now going to drop more rocks.
That's terrible.
Into the three lit up holes. And see how nothing happens for a while? And then the door opens? Yeah, that caused me to fuck up this puzzle a number of times. I think that's a measure to prevent you from guessing at the answer. Right? So you can't just drop rocks down the holes and see when the door opens.
Because if you drop it down the wrong hole, I presume those teleporters fuck everything up.
Well, getting the right answer both opens the door and lets you in here.
Mm-hmm.
If we pick up the rocks, the door will close again. The button that teleported the spider also teleports the rocks or whatever's on the switches back to where you can grab it through that grate.
Right, yeah.
So it allows you to reset the puzzle. But basically what happens is because of that delay, I kept going downstairs and I found the secret, but I didn't see the door open, so I thought that I had not solved the puzzle.
And you kept resetting it?
And I kept resetting it and running around for a bit before I realized it was the secret and the door were the same solution. Here, if you remember, there was that gate and we saw something on that pedestal on the other side. So it's right on the other side of that wall, so we can reason... And here's our plinth. So we can reasonably assume that there is a secret button here somewhere. We're gonna find it. Ah, there it is. And we found the pants.
Like a plate.
And a shortcut to get back and forth. We actually have a nice we're getting to a nice collection of heavy armor here.
Might be time to actually start giving Cowjay heavy armor skill.
Yeah, one more. Next level he gets, he will be able to pick up heavy armor. Also, with this shortcut, we can go back and rescue our friends.
Yes. No rock left behind.
It's very important. It's actually secret ending. The true ending is unlocked by getting all the rocks in the game. No, it's not. That's a lie.
I know that the island is just a very giant version of the boss in the first game. And you have to fight it.
I thought for a second you were saying, find out the island's just really a giant rock, and you have to save its babies. And then I was like, well, the island is a giant rock. So I dropped those other three rocks. I'm like, I could go back and get those too, but that's a really long walk. And then I thought to myself, they'd do the same for me.
It would just take them much longer.
It would take them a lot longer. So we're going to go and get them. Come on, guys. There we go. I really thought about editing in one of the scenes from Futurama where Fry is going to dive into lava to go rescue his dog, and he yells, "He'd do the same for me!" And I was going to edit it in right there, but I was lazy, so I didn't.
You still have time.
Also copyrights, I suppose. This is when I realized that. This is when I realized that, one, I probably could have edited it out, and two, I should have just gone them all on the same trip, but whatever.
Alright, back to progress.
Okay, yeah. So remember that sign said, Tower of Meditation, something like that?
Tower of Meditation, Temple of Doom.
Return of the Empire.
No, you're supposed to climb the tower.
Well, no, what's at the bottom, though? You know how it works. If there's one way you're obviously supposed to go, all the good stuff is in the other way.
Except when it is not.
Yeah. Hey, we got two bombs.
Yeah, I guess that was worth it. And some bread.
Which is really experience. So bread's cool. And we're doing this for absolutely no reason at all. No reason at all.
That's just going to be surrounded by mummies, aren't you?
And we're saving for
no reason at all. Yeah.
So, the first time I did this, I remember I didn't even hit the save crystal, and I jumped down the pit, and then I couldn't get back to the save crystal. And then, when it said meditation, I sat here for a minute, and I thought to myself, well, nothing's happening. Maybe it means I need to sleep. So I did. It doesn't mean you need to sleep, it means you need to wait a long time. And what it does, eventually, is teleport you to a room with three ice elementals in it, who had surrounded me in my sleep and instantly murdered me. Yeah, it didn't go so hot. Even if you know these guys are here, they're still very likely to kill you. So, this is my second attempt at it. Or is it? Oh shit, I forgot to edit that out. This is my first attempt at it. I'm gonna die.
Oh man.
But this
quality
is why,
LP.
This is why I got all those bombs, because these guys hurt. And it's not a big open area. It's not super easy to dodge. And eventually, if they surround you, you are just fucking dead. And at this point, I'm like, oh, I am so fucking dead.
I still think that you should have, like, the first time. Like, if you're gonna screw it up, like, screw it up in the way that you explained, just by sleeping and waking up and being like, oh, surrounded by dudes who patiently waited for me to wake up before murdering me.
Yeah, they murdered me right quick. I probably died in, like, 20 seconds, tops. There was only three of them, so they didn't surround me completely, but even running away, I didn't make it. I'm actually really sorry. I forgot to edit this out because these loading screens kind of take a while. But whatever.
Still
too late now. No, there isn't. If I had a time machine, maybe I could go back and warn myself, Agent, you're going to forget to edit something out. Don't do it, or the enemy Skynet goes online. Yeah, that. Anyhow, now we're going to sleep again, which is. Wonderful planning on my part. I think I actually go bear form for this as well.
Excellent. Oh, wait, this is actually a secret? It's not required for progress?
Yep, this is a secret. Also, that was the arcubus
misfiring?
Backfiring.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah, you can now. Not only do you have a chance to miss with your weapon, right? And not only do you have a chance to have it jam and waste your turn, you have a chance for it to explode in your face. I don't understand why guns are so bad.
Are you kidding? I'd be using more than one guy with guns just because that's fantastic.
Double kill. All right. Okay, there's one left. I'm pretty sure I can kill him without him killing any of my dudes.
I was promised bear form. What is this shit?
The bear form comes later, I remember. Nobody saw that. Nothing happened.
Well, at least the jam doesn't take very long.
No, the jams actually happen really quick. It's the... and I think misfires happen pretty quick, too. Now I run through the fire for... I don't know why. Oh, wait, no, I don't. That's later. Never mind, I don't run through the fire. Or that was a practice attempt. Could have been that, too.
Well, I have to insist that you give a speed potion to the rat next time so he can misfire twice as often.
Yeah, notice how often I failed to shoot. I failed to shoot more than I actually shot. And I'm an alchemist, so I have innate half chance of failure, and I have 3 levels of firearms, which lowers it even further, so I don't quite understand why firearms are so bad.
Well, the thing is that you have so much ammo, and it does do pretty good damage now that you're not using your starter pistol.
Yeah, now it does do reasonable damage, so it'll be fine. And in another couple of levels, because I don't have anything else to put the points into, he won't have any chance of misfiring at all, and then I think it will be almost approaching decent. But we'll find out.
I think you probably could have afforded to have more levels of firearm earlier.
Yeah, but the potions are really good. I mean, I've brewed bombs a bunch. And it tripled the amount of bombs I get, remember? Normally I would only get 1 bomb.
Yeah, I guess that's right.
And he's really more of a utility character anyway. So we got another piece of heavy armor. We got a skull, which is always nice.
Look,
and
I don't care if he's a healer, he still needs to contribute.
Well, he also talks the leader skill, which gives everyone else +1 to all stats, which is probably his best contribution. The scroll that you got at the top of the plinth shoots a ray that damages elementals. Which, one, has the best symbol you have to make ever. Just all the buttons.
In the correct order?
Yeah. Yeah, you can't just hit all the buttons in a random order. It has to be the right one. But, yeah, I can't cast it, obviously, but that's pretty cool.
Because it's a water spell.
Yeah, the fire and air are the two trees you want to have if you just want to go out and out full-on damage. Which, I mean, who doesn't want that?
I mean, take less damage if you end fights quicker.
That's true.
Also applicable to Darkest Dungeon.
Which is a great game, which we have not mentioned enough. Yes, we have. Yeah, now is when the bear form comes out. Because these crabs, they kind of hurt, so I'm kind of prepping a bit. It's the benefit of always playing one time through the dungeon immediately before actually recording, is I'm like, oh yeah, that's right, this was hard, I'm just going to make potions beforehand.
Yeah, but it makes it for a really shitty blind LP.
Actually, but hold on, but if blind LPs are kind of shitty by default.
Not necessarily. I've seen some good ones.
But, so, we're going to go and we're going to kill crabs. But first, there's this button, which is hidden, and opens up a passageway over here.
Was there a serpent bracer in the first game?
Yes, there was. There was also a serpent bracer in the same place that we got the rope from. So this is actually our second serpent bracer. It's the thing that made Spelling Bee so hard to kill in the mushroom boss.
Oh, right, yeah, because he's so resistant to poison now.
Yep. Elemental resistances don't seem too important, though. I have not seen that many enemies who attack with elements.
I mean,
although
it's kind of nice.
I mean, if I did have water spells, I could cast water resistance for the party, which would have made those ice elementals easier, and you would have been able to cast dispel, so that probably would have been pretty nice. I thought that maybe he could equip a spear and attack from the back row, but the spear's two-handed.
Oh, right.
But if he could attack from the back row, then you could just make bear form front row guy all the time. Or at least give him an option to attack while he's in bear form. The secret door, by the way, is on a timer. So if you did not run over here immediately, you would not find it.
But you'd hear it.
You'd hear it. If you got close, you'd hear it, and then you just go back and hit the button again. So it's time to kill some crabs. These guys have a lot of HP, and they hit really hard, so I really don't want to take any attacks at all. They also really like inflicting injuries, which is wonderful.
Are you gonna go to stomp them?
No, the crabs won't follow you down the pit.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, that was short-lived.
Yeah. They kind of hurt. But I got those potions of resurrection, so whatever. I actually have a couple of crystals of resurrection, too, which actually heal your entire party to full and revive everybody, just like you had touched a
save crystal.
I found that out because most of my party died fighting the ice elementals in my practice file, and I didn't want to reload and try again. So I just used one, and I was like, oh, this is great.
Only had a mace and some butter. Things are probably tasty.
They probably are, but they're more like crabs than lobsters, so maybe we should just like wait and come back when they're soft shells and put them on a giant sandwich.
God, that's such a pain. That soft shell crab is also delicious.
It is. So, I realize at this point that I'm backing up the wrong way.
Whoops.
So I'm backing up into uncharted territory, and I know there's something here, so I'm gonna intentionally go jump down this pit, because this thing can follow me down, but the crap can't.
Ah, okay. I was hoping that you'd shoot the bug out of the air. You'd be a real
nope.
Wild West superstar.
No, unfortunately... God, those things hurt.
I'm sorry, I was just laughing at the fact that you sidestepped and so did it. Because, of course, it's a crab. It can crab walk.
It's a crab. Yeah, that's how it works.
That may be my favorite detail of the entire video so far.
mine was the poop joke. And what do you get as a reward? 10 bullets and 3 arrows. Whoop-dee-fookin-doo. Yeah. That fight was way harder than 3 arrows and 10 bullets was worth.
But you got a bunch of experience.
That's true. The experience is probably worth more. And who knows, maybe they had a chance of dropping crab steaks, which would have also been nice.
Crab legs.
Crab claws. But, moving forward, we're actually making a big-ass circle, and here we are back at the save crystal.
Yeah. I was going to say, all this talk about eating crabs make me really hungry for crab, but I actually had soft-shell crab sushi the other day.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Here's the opposite of the light spell. It goes dark. I don't actually know if it's harder for enemies to see you, and if you might actually want to use that spell if, you know, you had backstabs. But there it is. That looks like an axe, kind of. Looks like a fancy axe with a blue handle, which
yeah.
Means I want it very badly. But I don't have a gold key yet, so...
Well, looking at the map, it looked like there might have been a secret area where the crabs were.
There isn't. I know. Unless
thoroughly in the practice file.
Yeah, but I always check all the walls in the practice file when I'm doing it for fun, and then before the update, I will go back through and use a guide.
You're pointing directly at it. There should be a secret there.
It does look like there would be, but there is not. But we are almost halfway through this dungeon, but the video is already 40 minutes long, so we're going to cut it right here.
Yeah. It's a very long dungeon.
It's a very long dungeon. It's a really big place. There's a whole floor we haven't been to yet.
Softshell crab sushi, by the way, is really good. My sushi tastes are actually incredibly unrefined. Like, given the choice, I'll just get salmon and tuna and pretty much leave it at that. Oh, yeah. But I'll actually preferentially get spicy salmon and spicy tuna. But that's just mayo and sriracha. It is. Yeah. Well, not really, because here's the thing. If they don't like raw fish, there is still plenty of sushi that's cooked and is still tasty. Mm-hmm. And there's nothing wrong with smoke stuff. Yeah. All right, I'm going to stop recording, but